On Thursday, the Kenya Airports Authority management appeared before the Public Investment Committee to shed light on the proposed takeover of the Jomo Kenyatta International Airport by the Kenya Airways. KAA Chief Executive Officer John Anderson taken to task to explain why there was a rush to close the deal, despite there being some grey areas in the transaction.
Are you working under instructions from any quarters? Because you seem not to be responsible with the way you have presented your issues here.
I've never been involved in anything so big like this one before. It's a serious matter. And you may criticize me for being instructed, but I'm not. For the record, I am not. I will leave if I'm being told to do certain things.
The lawmakers also sought to know why KAA had been unable to furnish Parliament with cabinet meeting minutes approving the now controversial takeover. The Public Investment Committee said it will recommend that Parliament issues an injunction on the takeover until investigations into the transaction are complete.
Financially and legally, the exposure that you've already exposed us through right now, it is of our view that we should actually cease any further dealings to do with this.
While asking for the Auditor General to investigate the transaction between the Kenya Airports Authority and Kenya Airways, the MPs also sought to know why KQ, a company that has been on a downward spiral for years, is now looking to take over the Jomo Kenyatta International Airport despite owing the Kenya Airports Authority over 4.8 billion shillings. Meanwhile, Tourism Cabinet Secretary Najib Balala has denied that he irregularly awarded a 100 million shilling tender to the American Society of Travel Agents. While appearing before the National Assembly's Culture, Tourism and Sports Committee, Balala told MPs that Kenya had merely partnered with ASTA to host the 2017 Tourism Conference.
Ours is only sponsoring, part sponsoring of the event to take place. The event itself belongs to the travel agents and the association. Ours is just to make it happen.
Elsewhere, the Commission on Administrative Justice is seeking an additional 300 million shillings on top of its 500 million budget.
Mr. Chairman, we have sat and said that if we do not address the issues of maladministration within public service, if we do not address issues of delay in delivering public service to the people of Kenya, then even the Big Four agenda is going to be a big challenge to the leadership of this country.
The Ombudsman says the increment will go towards scaling up of its operations and presence across the country. For Channel One News, I am Edward Kabasa.